you go, we got our last flag without even needing to escalate privileges. Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Let's fuzz some files. My name's Ash, I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast, and on this video, we're gonna be finding some hidden directories on a web server via this Try Hack Me challenge. For all my notes, links, and timestamps, see the description, otherwise let's go. So I've logged into Try Hack Me, and we're on the room Root Me. This is a CTF for beginners, and the term root means gaining the most high access to a machine, being the root level. Or maybe it's the lowest access because you've got access to everything. We've got four tasks, so let's go and click on the first one. We'll go ahead and select start machine. Over onto task two, reconnaissance. Let's first get some information about the target. So I like that this is a little bit more of a walkthrough slash CTF. That's a nice combo. So it says scan the machine, how many ports are open. So it takes about a minute to get our IP. So we can't ping it straight away. So maybe ICMP is blocked. So ping packets are blocked, or perhaps it might just take a couple more minutes. So this is an important lesson to go back and ping 10 to then 10 to make sure that you're actually on the network. So actually looks like there's a problem on my end. So I'm gonna go restart my VPN connection. Okay, after a quick restart, we're back on these VPN and we ping our machine, we can now see it. Cool, let's go ahead and try this Rust scan again, and as we were expecting to see, we see a 22 and an 80. So we have some SSH we might have to log into, but let's start with our lowest hanging fruit being our HTTP. Cool, and we can confirm that's definitely what's running on these ports. Let's run this again, but this time we want to look for more information against those ports. While that scan's running, let's navigate over via the browser, and we just have a root at root me. All right, looking at the view source, looks like we don't really have anything. So before we go too deep, let's go back to our page here and let's go and start answering these. So scan the machine, how many ports? So far we've only seen two. All right, cool. And it's asking us for what version of Apache. So Apache being a widely used web server software, we are gonna get that from our further Nmap results. So we can see it here under that port 80. And we can paste that in. So then next up, it says, what service is running on port 22? And we can already confirm that from earlier, we're running SSH. And next up, it's directing us to use GoBuster or a directory busting tool. And then we're gonna be looking for a hidden directory. So I'm gonna be using Ferox Buster. Then we always do, let's just go ahead and use a word list. And I've been liking this medium list and also specifying perhaps some other file extensions. So straight away, we do get and uploads. Okay, so that's kind of interesting. There might be an upload point where information goes here. Maybe we can do a reverse shell to get access. We have a CSS, which we can quickly have a look through. Maybe there's a comment in here. No, it's always good just to check. There's also a JS file. So this is just containing that typewriter animation we saw at the beginning. Otherwise, nothing of interest there. We found a panel directory. So now we've found our two points of interest. We have an upload area and we have an area for uploads. Let's go back to our hidden directory and type that in. So moving on to task number three, find a form to upload and get a reverse shell and find the flag. So it's really telling us where to go and what exactly to do. All right, so we wanna sort of test what files we can actually upload. So I'm gonna copy this URL. Let's open Burp Suite, go target sitemap and open up a browser so we can start inspecting traffic and we can do some cool stuff. Alrighty, go to the proxy intercept and turn that on. So I'm just gonna go ahead and make a file.php. Then I'm gonna go ahead and select the file.php and go upload, and that's captured this request. So we can see here we've got the file name file.php. So this is what we wanna sort of get some more info on. Can we upload this and can we upload a lot of others? So we can do it manually by the repeater, or we can go over to Intruder to sort of automate a larger list. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll clear all of that and we just want to grab PHP and go add. That's going to put in, I think these are like variables for this attack. So we'll go payloads. It's going to be a simple list. We're going to load in, I think sec lists, fuzzing. We can go for like this extensions most common dot fuzz. That's not too big of a list. Let's go ahead and try this. All right, then we can go on our response and we can look at the rendered page and we can just scroll through these and looks like, all right, so some things don't work. ASP, ASPX worked, PHP doesn't. Now, given that this is an Apache, we do want PHP so we can access it, hopefully successfully execute a PHP reverse shell. Okay, PHP 3 works, PHP 4 works, PHP 5 works, so we can try out some of those. So we'll go to revshells.com and we can generate a PHP reverse shell. Pentest Monkey works really well. Then we just want the IP of our local machine and then whatever port we want to go on. All right, let's copy that. Let's go ahead and create a shell.php. So we had 3, 4, or 5. So we need to test which ones exactly will work, but I'm going to go PHP 5. And we can just paste in our reverse shell. Triple check that we've got the right IP to your local machine and our port. Save that off. Then we just go copy that listener. Okay, so we've got our listening port. So we'll go back to browse. We'll select the shell PHP 5 that we just created and we'll go upload and we have an upload success message. So assuming that this goes where I think it goes. All right, now we can see a big old list of all the fake files. They're all 0 bytes of information, so they don't have anything. They were just requests. But our shell.php 5 does have something in it. So let's select that. And if we go back to our shell, we have access. Awesome. And using my hack notes, we can use an upgrade shell here. We'll paste that in, control Z, paste that in, and lastly, paste that in. Select enter, and now we just have a bit of a nicer shell to work with. Okay, so we are looking for some user.txt. So a good place to always try and start is our Etsy password. See if we have some users that are of interest. So it looks like they've got some home directories. So then let's just list out the directories of that. So we've got our rootme and our test like we just saw. I'm not seeing a user.txt. So how about we go home for this user? All right, cool, there we are. All right, there is our first flag. Paste that in. Awesome. Last task, we have privilege escalation. Now that we have a shell, let's escalate our privileges to root. Search for files with SUID permissions. Which file is weird? So to find our SUIDs, we can use the find command, look anywhere with the permissions of this, and let's just get rid of the errors that we're going to see. Let's go ahead and run that. Okay, cool. That's going to give us a big old list. So it's asking us out of this list, which file seems a bit weird. That one seems a bit weird. This one seems weird too. And it matches what it's asking for. Okay, so this is guiding us towards what we need to use. So we need to use Python somehow. It says find a form to escalate your privileges. So if we look up SUID Python, that's going to show us GTFO bins. And this is our go-to for this sort of things. So we can escalate using this, but if we go down to file read, we can look at any file. So we likely know that the last file is in that root directory, which we can't see. So root don't got no access. But because I've played other CTFs, we know that it's usually in there once we get root access. So we're going to do something a little bit tricky. If we paste in what we can use with our privileges, so without even getting a shell, I want to look in root, and there's probably a root.txt waiting for me. And there you go, we got our last flag without even needing to escalate privileges. All right, let's paste that in. And there we go. That was the room rootme on TryHackMe. So thanks for sticking around and watching up until the end. Up on the screen, you're gonna see a recommendation for the other TryHackMe room called Pickle Rick, which has some good info about other hidden directories and using bash to see around the file system. So thanks again, guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.